Everyone, in this video let's see the different classifications of mutual fund. These mutual funds are widely classified into four categories, that is operational classification, portfolio classification, geographical classification, structural classification. These are the four heads under which the mutual funds are classified. Let's see the first one, operational classification of mutual fund. On the basis of its operation, mutual funds are classified into three types, that is open-ended mutual fund, closed-ended mutual fund, interval fund. So first one, open-ended mutual fund. If you see here, it says open-ended mutual funds are the open throughout the year for investment and redemptions. The units are bought and sold directly by the fund. It means here these mutual funds, they do not carry any specific period within which the purchase and sale has to be done. It means these funds are open throughout the year. Whenever you want to buy the units, you can go and buy these units from this mutual fund. That is open-ended schemes. There is no specific time within which you have to make the purchase. Therefore, it is open-ended mutual fund. Second one, closed-ended mutual fund. It is a opposite to open-ended mutual fund. Here it says the units are offered to the investors through public issue, and after the dates of closure, the entry to the investor will be closed. It means there will be a specified period which will be mentioned by the mutual fund. Within that period itself, you have to make the purchase. After the closure of the period, you will not be able to make the purchase and sale of the units of closed-ended mutual fund. Specific period will be there. Within that period itself, purchase and sale should be done. That is closed-ended mutual fund. Third one is interval fund. Interval fund combine the features of open-ended and closed-ended schemes. Here, both the features of open-ended and closed-ended are there in interval funds. It combines both the features of open-ended and closed-ended mutual fund. Here open-ended, it is open throughout the year. Closed-ended, within a specified period, purchase and sale should be done. Interval fund combines both open-ended and closed-ended mutual fund. Second type of classification, it is portfolio classification. Portfolio, combination of securities. When you design a portfolio, you usually carry a intention. You will have certain needs. In order to meet that needs, you are designing the portfolio. Therefore, here portfolio classification is made on the basis of your needs. Now, first one, growth oriented funds or equity oriented funds. The major aim of this fund is growth. If you want to have a capital appreciation, then you may have to go for growth oriented funds or equity oriented funds, mainly investing your money into equity shares of different companies, that is growth oriented funds. Here, since you are approaching growth or capital appreciation, the risk will be high in this case, that is because you are investing your money into equity shares. Second one, income or debt oriented funds. It says income, therefore the main objective is earning income on a regular if you want regular income, then you may have to go for income or debt oriented funds. Here your money will be invested in debentures, that is why it says debt oriented fund, or preference shares. Since it is income oriented fund, preference share also consists of fixed income. Therefore, either your money will be invested in preference shares or debentures of different companies. They provide regular income to you. That is income oriented. Third one is balanced funds or income and growth oriented funds. It is a combination of income oriented fund and growth oriented fund. It means your money will be equally distributed between equities and debt securities. Equity shares, some amount will be invested in equity shares, some will be invested in preference and debentures of the company, so that you will earn regular income. At the same time, some amount will lead to capital appreciation. Next one is bond funds. Here your fund will be invested in bonds of government. Here it is mainly for liquidity. It provides more safety, we can say. Here it is because it carry lower risk. The money invested by you will be reinvested in bonds of government. Third one, last one is stock funds. Stock fund, here your money will be invested in the common stock, exactly similar to growth oriented funds. Here entire amount of your money, it will be invested in the common stocks of industrial corporations. It is highly riskier one because you are investing in common stocks or equities of different companies. Here you are not earning regular return. On the other hand, you are aiming for capital appreciation, which is similar to growth fund. So under portfolio classification, we have growth oriented fund where money will be invested in equity shares, income oriented fund where money will be invested in either debentures or preference shares, balanced fund, a combination of income and growth funds, money equally distributed between equities and debentures, bond fund, your fund will be invested in bonds, stock fund, investment will be done in common stocks. Next one is geographical classification. This is based on the geographical area. So here two things, that is domestic mutual fund and offshore mutual funds. So domestic mutual fund schemes mobilizes the savings of the country's citizens. This scheme is meant for citizens of a particular country. You are investing your money in India, then it is domestic fund. Here foreigners can also invest, but it is specifically meant for domestic citizens. Second one, offshore mutual fund. These are the funds enable NRIs and international investors to participate in the Indian capital market. It means it is a fund which is meant for NRIs, that is non-resident Indians, and international investors. They are coming and investing their money into our market, that is for foreigners. So domestic mutual fund meant for domestic citizens, offshore mutual fund meant for foreigners. These are the two things which comes under geographical classification. Next one is structural classification of mutual fund. Based on the structure of mutual fund, it is classified into two things, that is capital market mutual fund and money market investment, money market mutual fund. Capital market, here your money will be invested in capital market. Money market, money mutual funds will be invested in money market. Capital market investment, they are invested for a longer period, that is for a period more than 1 year. So here your money will be invested in shares, bonds and debentures which are having longer maturity. On the other hand, money market instrument consists of treasury bills, government securities and other certificates which carry a shorter maturity, that is within 1 year. So that is about structural classification of mutual fund. These are the four areas in which mutual funds are classified: on the basis of operation, on the basis of portfolio classification, on the basis of geographical classification, and the last one is structural classification of mutual fund. Thank you.